So in this video, I'll show you how easy it is to create a video from just a few images. So let's start by coming to this left-hand side here where it says images and video. And I will add a few pictures that I've downloaded. So let's see. Alright, here's the images. Alright, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 of them. And you can actually also add from the internet directly. So you just, you know, specify the links to the images. But in this case, it's all on my local computer. So the next thing is to add some text to each of these images, like captions. So to do that, again, I'll add from my PC. So I've already got a text file prepared, and the program is actually smart enough to actually split the text so that each sentence corresponds to a slide. Alright, so I will say text position top, text font, and maybe put this to 20 points for the size. This color is white on black. That's alright. Save it. And then, as you can see, it immediately updates. So let's say, for example, this slide. Let me double click and see what we've got. You can see that this is a picture, and here's the caption. And if I want to change the position of the caption, I can do it for all the slides. I can select and say text position bottom. So if I do that, if I click it again, you can see that the caption is now at the bottom. And let's actually increase the size of the text. So text settings, font size, it's a bit small. I'll put it to 22. And I'll say save for selected slides. And then, yep, that looks much better. Alright. And then, so you can see that each picture stays on the screen for 5 seconds. So let's actually change it a bit. Let's say duration, custom duration, let's put this to 7 seconds, and maybe let's see, let me rearrange this so that this slide comes last. Okay, that looks much better. And okay, so it's at the top. I will have to put it at the bottom and also align it center. So now you can see that it's bottom and aligned center. Perfect. I can change the duration of this last one to maybe 10 seconds. And that looks good. And now let's actually add some transitions as well. You can see that there's all kinds of transitions. I will simply choose them randomly. Maybe radial wipe, spiral transition, random dissolve, strips, checkerboard, and let's say, and how about a zigzag for the last one. Alright, so that looks pretty good. What else do we want? Let's actually click on create video. And Okay, let's put this onto the desktop. Alright. And let's name this. So this is actually Star Trek Beyond Review. Okay. Add audio background. Yes, let's actually put in an audio file which I have prepared. Okay, and volume 100, it's all right. So the quality, yeah, that's all right. 1280 by 720. Now this will take a little bit of time because it's high quality file, or I can just save tree and then generate videos normal. So I do want the transitions to be rendered. Okay, so all that looks good. So let me click on start, and you can see the progress over here on the left. So it's pretty, it shouldn't take too long for this video because it's only what, 1 2 3 4 5 6, it's only about 50 seconds long. So it should be done in no time. But you can see that all this process didn't take me that long, right? It's just a process of just importing some images, and you can actually import videos as well, but in this example, to make it simple, I've only used images. It looks like the rendering's finished. So let me come to my desktop and let me play this video in media player. All right, looks pretty good. So the caption comes across clearly, the transitions work. Very nice. I hope that that you've had a taste of what you can do with Video Spin Blaster Pro. It's easy to use, and you can put up a quick video in no time at all. So, thank you for watching.